In this video, we're making crochet shoes for our 18-inch classic semi-dolls. Start off by chaining 10. If you are new to crochet, I invite you to check out my Learn to Crochet for Beginners video series on YouTube. It's linked down below in the video description. We are starting off with a slip knot, and then we are going to make 10 chain stitches. And now we're going to start in the second chain stitch from the hook. We're going to make one half double crochet, and then we're going to continue to make one half double crochet each into the next 7 stitches as well. So it's a total of one half double crochet into the next 8 stitches here. And once we made our 8 half double crochets, this is the 8th one. Now we're going to make 6 half double crochets into the next stitch. So the next 6 half double crochets all go into the same stitch here. And now we can pull on the yarn tail to make that stitch a bit smaller. Now we're going to continue to make one half double crochet each into the next 8 stitches. And next we're going to make 5 half double crochets into the next stitch. So they all go into the next stitch. And then we close the round with a slip stitch, and we're starting off the next round with a chain stitch. There's our chain stitch. Now we're going to make one half double crochet each into the next 8 stitches again. Next, we're going to make 2 half double crochets each into the next 6 stitches. So 2 half double crochets go into the same stitch. And first we can cut off the yarn tail here. We've been working it into the shoe sole here quite a bit, so it's all nice and secure. And now we can make our two half double crochets, each into the next 6 stitches. And now we can continue with our half double crochets, so one half double crochet each into the next 8 stitches. And now we can make 2 half double crochets each into the next 5 stitches. And we end the round with a slip stitch and begin the next round with a chain stitch. And we're going to, so there's our chain stitch, and now we're going to make 1 half double crochet each into the next 8 stitches again. Next, we're going to work in a pattern, so we're going to make 2 half double crochets in the first stitch and then just 1 half double crochet into the one after that. 2 half double crochets in the first stitch and then just 1 into the one after that. And we're going to repeat this 6 times. And now we can make 1 half double crochet each into the next 8 stitches again. And now we're going to work in our pattern again. 2 half double crochets into the first stitch and 1 half double crochet into the stitch after that. And we're going to repeat that 5 times this time. And we are ending the round with a slip stitch and starting off the next one with a chain stitch again. And now we're going to make 1 half double crochet each into the next 8 stitches again. The next pattern that we're working in will be 2 half double crochets in the first stitch, then 1 half double crochet in the second stitch, and 1 half double crochet in the third stitch. And we're going to repeat that 6 times. So it's going to be 2, 1, 1. So 2 half double crochets into the first stitch, 1 half double crochet into the one after that, and 1 half double crochet into the one after that one. So 2, 1, 1, and we're going to repeat that 6 times. And now we can make 1 half double crochet each into the next 8 stitches again. And we're going to work in the same pattern here as well. So we're going to make 2 half double crochets into the first stitch, then 1 half double crochet into the following one, and 1 half double crochet into the one after that. So 2, 1, 1. And we're going to repeat this 5 times this time. And we are ending the round with a slip stitch and beginning the next round with a chain stitch again. And in this round we're only going to work in the back loops because we want to make the size of the shoe now. And usually I would go through those two loops of the stitch. Now I'm only going into the back loop, and I'm also picking up a loop from the previous round, so I still have two loops to work with. But if you like, you can only work in the back loops as well, that works as well. So we're going to make single crochets into the back loops, or the back loop and one loop of the previous round, and we're going all the way around. So I'm just going to skip ahead and skip forward to the end of the round because you know what I'm doing here and we don't have to watch the whole thing and make the video file so large that it takes me a few days to upload it. And now we're at the end of the round, and we're going to finish the round with a slip stitch, and we're going to start off the next round with a chain stitch. And here's our chain stitch, and now we're going to make one half double crochet each into every single stitch of the round. And I'm going to skip forward to the end of the round here as well. You can pause the video here if you like, and then turn it back on if you're getting close to the end of the round. And here we are at the end of the round. We're making our slip stitch, and we're going to repeat the same thing in the next round. So we're going to start off the round with a chain stitch again, and then we're going to make one half double crochet each into every stitch of the round all the way around. And I'm going to skip ahead here as well again, and you can pause the video until you are done with your round. And here we are at the end of the round, and we're going to make our last half double crochet, and then we're finishing the round with a slip stitch. And we're starting off the next round with a chain stitch. And then we're going to make single crochets into the next 7 stitches. So one single crochet each into the next 7 stitches. And now we can make one half double crochet, and then we're going to make 2 double crochets together 12 times. So we're going to crochet 2 stitches together with a double crochet, and we're going to repeat that 12 times. And if you want to watch this in more detail and see how it's done, the 2 double crochets together, I invite you to have a look at the Crochet for Beginners series on my channel. It's linked down below in the video description and also at the end of the video. And we're just going to repeat this now until we have done it 12 times. And now we're going to make one half double crochet into the next stitch, and then one single crochet each into the next 7 stitches. And after we're done with our 7 single crochets, we're going to finish the round by making half double crochets into every single stitch. So one half double crochet each into every single stitch of the round until we're back at the beginning of the round. And I'm just going to skip ahead to the end of the round here as well, because it's just half double crochets now. And here we are getting back to the end of the round. We can make our slip stitch now. It's a bit fiddly this time around. And we're starting off the next round with a chain stitch again. And then we're going to make one single crochet each into the next 7 stitches. And now we're going to make one half double crochet into the next stitch, and then we're going to make 2 double crochets together 6 times. So we are decreasing the width here by double crocheting 2 stitches together 6 times. And now we're going to make one half double crochet into the next stitch, and then we're going to make one single crochet each into the next 7 stitches. And once we've made our 7 single crochets, we're going to finish the round by making one half double crochet each into every single stitch of the round until we're back at the beginning. And I'm going to skip ahead to the end of the round here as well, because it's just one half double crochet each into every single stitch of the round until we're back at the beginning. And here we are again, almost back at the beginning of the round, making our last half double crochet. And then we can end the round with a slip stitch. And we're starting off the next round again with a chain stitch. And this round is super easy and nice and relaxing. We're only going to make single crochets this round. So one single crochet each into every stitch of the round. And we're going to skip ahead to the end of the round again, because it's just single crochets. So here we are, almost back at the beginning of the round. And then we can finish the round with a slip stitch. And we're starting off the next round with a chain stitch again. And now it's time to make our shoe ties. So we're going to chain 40 stitches, and then we're going to make slip stitches all the way back down on the chain, back down to the shoe edge. And once we made our 40 chain stitches, we can start making slip stitches all the way back down. I'm starting in the second stitch from the hook. In the beginning it's a bit fiddly until we have something to hold on to here, and then it becomes a bit easier to make slip stitches into every single chain stitch all the way back down to the shoe edge. And I'm going to speed this up in a little bit. Just because it's the same thing and not too interesting to watch, and then you can just pause it as you need to. Now we're almost back at the shoe edge again with our slip stitches. And then we're just going to continue with the slip stitch, and we're going to make slip stitches into the next 22 stitches along the shoe edge here, and then it's time to make the second shoe tie. And now we're going to chain 40 stitches again, make 40 chain stitches again to make our second shoe tie. And I just sped it up a little bit, so we made our 40 chain stitches, and then we made our slip stitches all the way back down, and now we're almost back at the shoe edge. And then we're just going to finish the round by making slip stitches into every single stitch of the shoe inch here. And once we've done that, we can finish the shoe. So I'm making the last slip stitches here of the round. Sometimes I make one or two or three stitches more because I think it's very decorative, it looks quite nice. And then I can take my pair of scissors and cut off the yarn here. Then I'm going to pull the yarn through the last stitch. And then I take my wool needle and sew the yarn into the shoe so you can't see it anymore. And then I can cut it off, and the first shoe is done. So now I just have to repeat this another time, so I have another shoe for the dolly. Thank you so much for making this crochet project with me. I hope you enjoyed it a little bit, and I hope your dolly loves her new shoes. If you want to have a look at the other doll shoe sizes, they are linked down below, as well as the video beginner series. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and it was useful to you. Please give me a thumbs up, it really helps me out. Subscribe for more videos, and if you want to support me, head on over to my website and have a look at my patterns. The link for the website is down below in the video description. I'm really grateful to your support. I hope I see you in the next video. Bye!